Hi everyone, so us captains here, we've had the privilege to come back to school, so we understand that everyone back home, you guys are all in remote learning and it's very tough. So this week is Men's Health Week, if you everyone doesn't know that. So we just want to raise awareness that everyone looks out for each other's mental health. Just make sure by the end of the day, you just text or give each other a call just to see how things are going, just to make sure your mates are all right, and yeah.
Some of the issues that men face are loneliness, stress, depression and anxiety, and suicide. It is reported that men find it extremely difficult to open up due to the social pressures placed on them by society. I just want to let you know that it is okay for a man to speak up about their issues. It's not always going to be easy, but getting help is the first step in overcoming this hill.
The suicide rate for men is at an all-time high globally, and it's very sad that most men think that they can't get help in the sport that they need. It is okay to speak up about your issues. It is okay to open up your feelings. We're all here for each other, and the significance of men's mental health is not to be taken lightly.
Men's mental health is a big priority for this generation, and I believe that we can achieve much more accomplishments if mental health was addressed more amongst men. I encourage all of you to take action and speak up when you need to. There's no need to be afraid of being judged by others, and we're all here to support each other. Don't ever bottle up your feelings and let it be known that we do care about you.
Hey guys, how you going? Thought I'd share a couple of my own thoughts about why I think Men's Health Week is so important. So growing up, I had this attitude where I just wanted to be able to push through everything. You know, I didn't want to ask for help. I thought that was a sign of weakness. I wanted to be the person who projected this image where, like, you know, nothing fazed me. I could do everything. Nothing was too much for me. I could handle everything. I was completely on top of everything. I just wanted to have this image of just like, you know, I can do everything completely on my own. So if I was sick, I'd just push through it. You know, which given all the COVID stuff right now, seems like a very silly thing to do. If I was sore from a run, I wouldn't tell you. I'd just keep going. I wanted you to think that I was a super fit person who could handle every physical thing that came my way. If I was feeling anxious about something, I wouldn't tell anyone that. I'd just try and push through. I'd, you know, put a smile on my face and big thumbs up and kind of hide behind that, because I wouldn't want anyone to know that I actually was feeling anxious about something or I was concerned about anything. The whole she'll be right attitude that we seem to take in life, I don't think it's a show of strength at all. Seeking help does not make us weak, honestly. So do yourself a favour. If you've got something wrong, if you're feeling a bit low physically, if you're feeling a bit low mentally, just chat with a mate. Go see a doctor, get a checkup. It's not that hard. It is seriously the best thing you can do. I don't think that seeking help, I don't think that's a sign of weakness at all. Seeking help actually makes us strong. That's what Men's Health Week means to me.
Hey everyone, welcome to Mental Health Week of 2021. We are the members of the Keysborough Second Hearing Foliage Movember Team. I'm Mr. Martin, we're going to have Mr. Rizzo and Mr. Greeny have a chat with you guys about what we do in our everyday lives to ensure our mental health is good. So I do Movember every year, and I've done it every year since year 12. I've got a history of strokes, depression and cancer in my family, so I make sure that I do it every year just to sort of do my bit for that and make sure that we are putting towards research and things like that. Just things I do in my everyday life. If you've been in my classes, I'm sure you, every time you do have a chat with me, you leave with a smile. If outside of school, I make sure that I do a workout with Mr. Curry once a week, and we just have a chat with everything to do our sort of mental health wellbeing check-ins whilst lifting some heavy weight. I'll pass it on to Mr. Rizzo here, who's going to lead you through what he does.
Alright guys, yeah, so in my family there's like different things like diabetes, heart disease, tumours, cancers. I myself go through depression. It's an interesting thing to tackle, not going to lie. But you know, I always try and greet everyone with a smile in my classes. I've even had kids ask me why I always greet everyone with a smile. It's because I can and I want to. You know, make everything feel good for you guys. I usually deal with it by just, you know, playing music or listening to music a lot. Or maybe I'll just hop on some video games and just kill a few, you know, AIs, who knows. But I always like to talk out with mates and catch up with people, have some beers and just talk things through with everyone, because sometimes they have like different perspectives on many different things, and it's helpful and it gets you thinking and, you know, less worked up. So, yeah, you know, talking does help. What about you, Mr. Greeny?
I think for me, yeah, like mental health and well-being is really important. It can be really easy to, you know, get stuck in your own head and not communicate with people. I know that I've been a real victim of that sometimes, particularly, you know, over these last couple of years with lockdown and everything that's going on in the world. It can be really easy to isolate yourselves, particularly when we're, you know, in isolation. And, you know, it's really important to speak up and let people know how you're feeling, because there's always people in your life that really, you know, care for you and want to know how you're doing. So actually, you know, being vulnerable can be really difficult. It can be really hard to talk about those feelings, particularly for men. So yeah, just putting yourself out there and actually being honest with yourself and being honest with your mates and letting them know how you're actually going when they ask, you know, how are you, and not just saying the generic, I'm good, you know. If there's stuff going on, being honest and giving them a chance to open up as well. So yeah, just, you know, talking, being honest with your mates, and sort of going by that mantra of, you never know what people are going through, so be kind always, I think is really important, particularly in my life. So yeah, and doing, you know, different things with people to allow for those spaces to have those difficult discussions. So, you know, for me, that's usually going for a coffee, or you know, creating a space where you can sit and have a chat, going on a walk, stuff like that, where you're being deliberate about spending time with people and actually communicating and having an honest conversation. So
definitely awesome.
What I learned is that being a man is not about being physically strong or dominating your peers, or about being all-knowing about a certain topic, but rather being true to yourself and being your own hero, to follow your passions, whatever they may be, and to look out for others. For myself, I'm proud to say that two of my passions are a love of musicals and of Disney movies. Men's Health Week, I encourage all of you to reach out and start a conversation. It's important to open up to your friends and family if you are struggling. By talking about the things affecting us, we can take away their power over us and can begin to heal. By speaking up, you can also empower others to do the same. So stay safe, look after yourself, and be kind to those around you. And if it's something you enjoy, watch a musical or a Disney movie. Thanks.
Mental illness does not discriminate. Did you know that men can have mental illness, have an eating disorder, have an addiction, feel insecure, be bullied, feel emotion, and yes, even cry? It is not unmanly to struggle. Please know that it is okay to ask for help. Boys, young men at heart, remember to feel your feelings, reach out to connect, go inside yourself, and take action. Know these famous lyrics. Walk on with hope in your heart, and you'll never walk alone. Inspired by my 12-year-old nephew, just chill, just laugh, and go outside and live your life.
Hello, everyone. There are a lot of issues to tackle when it comes to improving men's health, but I want to focus on learning how to be emotionally vulnerable. At a young age, men are often taught by media, family, or society in general to not express how they feel. A lot of you have probably been told that boys don't cry, for example. However, the problem is that forcing everything down for so long can lead to harm, both for others and for yourself. When you're denying yourself the ability to show emotion, you end up expressing it through unproductive anger, sometimes violent anger. Breaking this conditioning starts with reflection and asking yourself questions about your life. What do you do in your free time? Does it fulfill you and make you happy, or does it make you feel conflicted or stressed afterwards? Do your friends listen to your concerns, or do they laugh them off? How do you act when you disagree with someone? If you answer these questions and realize you're not happy with how you are, reach out for help. Find someone who is kind and who will listen, be it a family member, a trusted adult, or a mental health professional. allow yourself the opportunity to express your concerns and worries in an environment where receiving help and feedback is the focus. Because I know that sometimes you feel that you're too far gone, that you invested so much time attaining this aggressively guarded version of masculinity, but that shouldn't stop you from changing and finding a healthy version of manhood. You deserve happiness and love, and allowing others to help you and allowing yourself to be honest about how you feel is the first step in attaining that.
Hi everyone! Men's Health Week is upon us, and I think it's the perfect time to speak up and share some thoughts about men's health and the issues that men face, both physical and emotional. I thought I'd start by sharing a personal story about my own emotional health and well-being. I'm doing this because I think it's important to share our own experiences so that we can grow from them and maybe help others to speak up too. When I was 5, my mother passed away. I cried at her funeral like any child would. But then I didn't cry again, not for a very long time. It wasn't until I was in year 10 that I cried for the first time in almost 10 years. I wasn't sure that crying was something that I could do. I'd always seen on TV and movies that men didn't cry. Men didn't share their feelings. I even heard that from some of my extended family, but I tell you what, they were wrong. When I cried again, I felt as though this heavy weight had been lifted from me. I felt confident sharing my feelings and speaking up for what I felt. I'd always had a great group of friends around me, but I realized then that they were not just physically there, they were there mentally for me. And I'm very lucky for that. I make sure now to always speak up when I'm feeling down or at least share my feelings with someone. Because it's important to know that you're not alone. You're never alone. There is always someone to talk to. Make sure to reach out to your family and friends or somebody that you trust. There's a great service in our country that's been growing for years and years, and that is the Men's Shed. This is a place purpose-built for men, both young and old, to come together and share. Share thoughts, feelings, and experiences. It's even a place for young men to learn from their elders some great new skills. If there was one thing I'd love everyone to think about this Men's Health Week, it's to know that it's always okay to reach out for help and to speak up. Thanks.
I think one of the biggest issues young men are facing when it comes to their mental health is this idea of toxic masculinity and what it means to be a man, and really challenging those ideas. And I think young people are getting better at it, but it's really important that men, young men in particular, step up and support one another when they see things that maybe don't fit that ideal. So like if they see a softer man or someone who is crying, like those things should be celebrated as a way of men being these really nuanced and diverse people that get to have those emotions as well. Things that I think do really well at celebrating that is MasterChef. You all know I'm a bit of a MasterChef tragic, but like the brotherhood in that is really celebrated, and the friendships that are created in that are really, really genuine and caring and loving, and I think that's a really important thing.
It's a struggle. A lot of men struggle. I'm not going to spit statistics and facts at you. That never worked on me. What I am going to tell you is this. I've been there. It's hard. I know it's hard. What you need to do, even if you're uncomfortable with it, is talk to somebody about your struggle. It is hard, but once you do, it feels so good. So, so good. I don't know what your particular struggle is, if you are struggling with something, but you need to sit with someone and say, hey, I need to talk to you, please listen. Because there is weight and strength behind those words. And when you do, once you get through it all, and in that process, it's a struggle. But once you get to the end of that, you feel so good about yourself. You feel so confident about yourself. And that's why I'm here. Because I've done that process and I feel good about myself. Yeah, good luck. I'm a bit of a big guy, not gonna lie. But I'm confident and comfortable with who I am because I went through that process. And I've struggled through that process. You can do it too. I believe in you. I might not know you, but I believe in you. And you can get through it.